Hello and welcome back to TC201. I hope you have already completed the first and the second modules by now. And please remember that if you haven't still done yet, the review questions at the end of each module is strictly time limited and they're due only 48 hours after they're posted. Having said that, let's start with today's session. The last time we talked about the fundamentals of telecommunication systems and looked at the basic elements of a network, we also talked about the waves, signals, and modulation. Today, we will talk more on the components of the telecommunication systems, and we will see transmission media basics. Transmission channels, starting with the wired ones, such as good old copper wires, twisted pairs, coaxial cables, or more modern, we will move on to the more modern solutions, such as fiber optics. We will also see and talk about satellites and microwaves. But let's start with the telecommunication networks. Communication networks is a fabric of elements which work together to support the information flow, or rather, transferring of the signal. Therefore, it's a systematic collection of transmitters, receivers, channels, and sometimes transceivers that allow communication with one another. It's often the case that some sort of repeaters or amplifiers are used in order to recreate and forward the signal if the distances are long, because the chances of attenuation increase and the power of the signal weakens along the way. Communication networks are actually circuits, sometimes big circuits. A circuit is a communication path between two or more nodes, just like the one you see in the picture. If you would like to hear more technical and detailed definition, you can pick from this list. For example, circuit can be defined as an electronic closed loop path among two or more points used for signal transfer. In communication protocols, it's the complete path between two terminals over which one-way or two-way communications may be provided. The circuits are the veins of the whole communication web. They are the core of the many layers that build up any communication device that you can think of. Actually, circuits are so important that we categorize most of the characteristics of the telecom systems by their circuit type. Basically, there are three types of circuits: dedicated, switched, and virtual. Dedicated circuits are the ones that have no intermediary points in connecting the two ends. That means if the circuit type of the phone line between your place and your grandmother's is dedicated, then there is just one long cable connected in between and nobody is sharing it with you. You pay nothing since you are not using any carrier and the line is yours for 24 hours, 7 days. If you want to set up such a line, it is available on a private basis, and they're mostly used when the security is utmost importance. So, for example, the red phone or the hotline between the White House and the Kremlin is a good example. Consider that you want to lay a whole new phone network to a town where the number of users will be hundreds or thousands. Going with the dedicated line is not the best solution, not the best cost-effective solution at least. You want to make this same line shared with the neighbors of the same street. And rather than wasting the bandwidth with allowing 24 hours, you want it to be available on demand. In that case, the type of the circuit you want to go with is switched. It's a type of circuit where there are intermediary switching devices to connect you and the phone you are calling to. Actually, it's not limited to phones only. It is the your station and the node that you want to connect it to. In the early days of telephony, this job was carried by women who were responsible for monitoring calls in front of big switching panels and connected the lines manually, one by one, by hand, which I believe was a very tedious job and a very boring one at the same time. We have been talking about switches, so let's give a brief definition. A switch is a circuit maker. In other words, is the device that establishes, maintains, or changes logical connections over physical circuits. Virtual circuits are the most modern ones. They work on the real physical circuits, but they handle enormous amounts of switching by help of logical processes, meaning that using computers, they do the switching job of a very busy, very crowded city, a child's play. They can come in two different forms. They can be permanently set or fixed, or dynamically determined depending on the need. As we can see from the variations of the network types and sizes, the capacity becomes a very important issue when studying telecommunication systems. The throughput is measured by various metrics depending on the type of network and the signal we are talking about. There are basically three types here. Hertz, mostly for measuring analog bandwidth waves. Baud, for digital communications, again bytes, again digital communications, bytes per second. And depending on the bandwidth capacity, a channel can be narrowband, wideband, or broadband. I'm sure you've heard these terms many times before, but let's give a look at their meanings. Baud is the number of distinct symbol changes or signaling events made to the transmission medium per second in a digital signal. Many data terminal equipments convert data into 8-bit binary sequences. This picture shows just one of them. So per 1 second, 8 bits of data is transferred. However, there are only 4 symbol changes within this 8 bits. Therefore, this transmission is called to have 4 bouts. Bandwidth is the essential capacity indicator, as we've just said. For example, a voice band channel is defined as having a 4 kHz bandwidth. A transmission channel like that would be called narrow band. Wideband, on the other hand, wideband channels are usually the channels that have wider channels than voice channels, but it is mostly a term used to contrast narrowband. They don't have a strict frequency limits. To be called broadband, a channel has to have more than 64 kilobytes per second and should provide multiple channels over a single medium. For example, smartphones and most internet connections are like that. The goal of information transfer is to get the greatest possible throughput within the bandwidth allocated for that specific service. Increasing the throughput either requires an increase in bandwidth, which results in obtaining more portions of the limited spectrum, or you can put more information on the existing bandwidth by using modulation, or if it's a digital one, by using compression. To connect one node to another, the method used changes as the type of the connection changes. For example, if you're talking about analog over the copper wires of phone lines, you could have circuit switching, which means that the physical path dedicated to single connection between the two ends remains during the call. The frequency allocated for the call belongs to the users as long as they talk. Whereas if you are talking about modern-day phone networks or internet connections, the frequency or the line never belongs to single users. Rather, the delivery of the signals are in small packets, and these packages are encoded with routing and addressing information that no matter how scattered their paths are over the world, they meet up and reach to the other end in a single piece and in their original form at the end. This way, the frequency is way more wisely used, and the frequencies also are shared among the many users of the same network. Packet switching is done logically, whereas the circuit switching is completely physical. So if you want to see them in action, let's have a look at these illustrations. The picture on the left is an example of switched circuit. So you can see that if Marion wants to call Alex, he needs to use the same line with Karsten, Chris, and Haley. And also, his call has to be switched at two points, namely X and Z. It's effective when compared to dedicated circuits, but not so when compared to virtual circuits and switching illustrated on the right. Here, the call Mario makes is distributed into small packages, you can see them in purple, and delivered to Alex along with many other packages. And the beauty of packet switching is the packages don't have to travel the same way, they don't have to go together. They can travel the paths which they find the fastest, most available, and least occupied individually. The communication in that case is called connection-oriented and makes more sense in terms of bandwidth use.